Hi guys, welcome to Darkknight Shey U Wan Drift video. Today I'll be with Hashim, the drifter himself. I will also be talking about Papa Smurf. We're going to tell you about drifting and a little bit about Hashim himself. Stay tuned. Welcome back once again. This is the man I told you about. This is Hashim himself.
Yeah.
Just I told you all about. So, Mr. Hashim, it's good to have you here. And
thank
I was
you.
Saying it's a very good car that you've got here, man.
Thank you.
I want you to tell us a little bit about yourself before going to the drifting thing proper.
Yeah, my name is Hashim. I'm into drifting a long time ago. Drifting, it's all about how to lose the car control and to control it back, you know? As in how to throw the car, then how to control it back, you know? So I'm going to educate you people today about drifting. We have three sections today. We are going to talk about the burnout, doughnuts, and the main drifting. So we are going to talk about it in details, and I'm going to talk about my car, Papa Smurf. It's a BMW E30. So that's what we're going to talk about.
So now you tell me more about Papa Smurf. I want you to tell us what you did to the car. I can see a lot of things. I can see iron and then a lot of things that you did. Even the painting is nice. I want you to tell us, how does this affect the drifting? Let's start with the engine part. How does that, do you do anything to the engine that will make the drifting better?
Exactly. When I bought this car, the first thing is mechanical, which is from the engine, you have to put a bigger radiator.
Okay.
And you have to put, I changed the double fan, as in you have two fans, because you know when you drift, you need a lot of power and for the car not to overheat, you know? So I put a bigger radiator, double fan, bigger engine setting, you know, for the engine setting is for the engine will not, because when you are drifting, you know, the car is going to one side, so the engine will not be shaking with you. Even some cars, the engine can come out from its place, you know? So that's why you have to have good engine setting, bigger radiator and double fan, as I said. And you have to always service, do the general service, which is the foil filter, oil filter, engine oil, the plugs, and your air filter. That's that the general service, you have to be servicing your car always. Then you will come to the back wheel. We have the back axle, that's the diff. I welded it for the two tires to spin together at the same time. You know, when you are drifting, when you are drifting now, as a BMW or Benz or whatever, any car that is back wheel normally just spin one tire will spin at a time. For better performance and better drifting, you have to weld your diff for both tires to spin in the same time. In your burnout, in your doughnut, in your drifting, you know? So that's for the mechanical part. You can see I did a very good body work.
Yes, I can see that.
And I painted it the design I want.
Papa Smurf
color. This is a boot spoiler. It's just a fancy boot spoiler for as a sport car, you know? So, and I removed, as you can see, I removed the two bumpers, the back bumper and the front bumper. So it's just because it's just a drift car. Just a drift car. It's not for cruising or any other thing. Just a drift car.
I see most cars, most drift cars, they have this.
Boot spoiler. Nah. This one's just a fancy design. Fancy.
So when you see a car that has this, just
exactly. And you know, like inside the car, I remove everything and put only two sport seats. As in, I throw all the follow comb seats, the back seats, the front seats. I remove everything from inside, even the carpet. I removed everything. It's empty. It's only the two sport seats inside with the sport steering. Yeah.
that enables you to drift
your car has to be light for better drifting. Yes, okay. Exactly. Yeah, that's why I even empty everything from inside the boot and the interior completely.
Okay.
So
what about your tires? What kind of tire would you advise somebody that wants to drift to use?
Yeah, you know, the tires, anytime you drift, you have always spare tires, because as you drift, your tire will just, it will just bust.
Okay.
So anytime you drift, you have to prepare your tires as spare. And anytime you drift, you have to visit your garage, your mechanic, to make sure your suspension, your engine oil, everything is still in place. Because you know, drifting and garage is the same place. Yeah, where you have to be visiting always.
Okay, where you know? Drift, then you have to.
Yes, of course, because for your safety.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, anytime you drift, you have to go let your mechanic cross-check your car.
Everything.
Yes.
Tires,
exactly. Everything. To the suspensions, he will check everything.
I want you to tell us, why is it that we don't see every kind of car drifting? This is a BMW E30. And
yes.
You are telling us that it drifts. I know not every car drifts, like the cameras. I want you to tell us why those cars don't drift.
Yeah, you know, like Japanese cars, Toyota Camry or Honda or Corolla or whatever, all those Japanese cars, the front wheel drive, they can't drift. You know, drifting is all about back wheel drive.
Okay.
You know, yes. And you know, it's not only about you taking a car and go and spin anyhow. That's not drifting.
Okay.
That's why you have to have a drift car, arrange it properly, and come to drift. And when you drift, the next thing is to visit your mechanic to cross-check everything for your safety.
An E30, BMW E30 is a drift car.
Yes, and you know, E30, you can install any engine you want,
okay.
Like a V8 engine, V10 and V12,
okay.
You know? E30 is basically a drift car. You know, people can as well use E36 and E46. It's BMW all as well.
Okay.
But E30 is the best drifting car.
Okay.
Yeah. Papa Smurf, I'm getting hydraulic handbrake. What is hydraulic handbrake? Hydraulic handbrake, I will replace it with the normal handbrake of the car. Yes, yes. So, you know, the hydraulic handbrake is very useful for drifting. Like if you are in the speed of 100 kilometers and you want to enter any bend you want, by the time you raise the hydraulic handbrake, it will lock the tires instead of the normal handbrake with the normal cables, which can cut anytime. Yes, so the hydraulic handbrake, it's very, very important in all the drift cars. You know, it's hydraulic. The cables will, the hydraulic will pass from the master cylinder through the back tires, you know, instead of using normal cables. Yeah, so it will lock, the hydraulic handbrake will lock the back tires. It will hold it well instead of the normal handbrake. Because the normal handbrake now, if you're entering any bend and you raise it, sometimes it can cut, which is not safe at all. Yeah, the hydraulic is hydraulic passing through the back tires, and it will lock the brakes very well. Yeah, that's it.
So Hashim, I know about a couple of drifting skills. Like I know about doughnuts, burnout. I want you to tell me a little bit about burnout.
You know, burnout is one of is the first actually section of drifting. It's when a car stopping in one place and you accelerate, your back tires will be burning the ground. You know, by the time you accelerate and that car is in one place and that your tires are just
is not moving,
it's just say yes,
that's burnout.
That is burnout.
Okay.
Yes, exactly.
Wow. Yeah. okay when the car spins and what happens to the car, it just stays one place and then
it will just stay one place.
Okay.
You know, when I accelerate, you'll see the back tires are just burning.
Okay.
That is burnout.
Okay.
Yeah.
I would love to see that.
Yeah.
You show it to us.
Yeah, of course.
I want you to tell me about doughnuts now.
Doughnuts actually.
Any kind of doughnut now.
So yeah. Donuts, it's look like you like doughnuts.
I do. I love doughnuts. I love doughnuts.
Doughnuts, yeah, you know, it's when you want to start. That's the second section of drifting. It's when you turn the direction of your tires, like if you want to spin onto your left, you turn your tires to your left, and you'll be, when you accelerate, the car will start burning round, you know? By the time it goes burning round, that you keep going round and round and round in some place. That's donuts. That's why they call it donuts, as in like, oh.
The tires are facing this way, and then the car is going that way.
Yes, the same, no, as in the same direction.
Same direction,
yes, exactly.
That's
when you're going same circle. That is donuts. That's why they call it donuts, it's a circle.
I thought that, okay, what about drifting? If going this way, and then your car is still turning this way, the same way of the tire, that is donuts. What about drifting?
Exactly, yeah, let me tell you. Yeah. You know, as in, that's what I'm telling you, the donuts, when you're, the direction is going the same way of the car turning.
Okay.
But drifting is when the car is turning to your right and the direction of the tire is left.
Whoa.
Is the opposite direction.
Oh, my tire is here and my car is going this way.
Yes, exactly, wow. Exactly, okay. Yes. That's drifting.
Okay.
Yeah.
Drifting.
Yes, the drifting is, yes. Donuts is one direction.
Okay.
And drifting is opposite. Your car is going like this and your tire is like this. Instead of your tire to be like this. The direction of your tire, you know?
Okay, all these cars, you see cars and you see them, you see them doing these stunts.
Actually, that's what we're trying to make awareness of that. Because, you know, they're using this Honda, you just speed and use his handbrake. He will just turn. Nothing impressive, you know? That's not even drifting, that's nothing, you know? So drifting is all about when you have a back wheel drive and you show us the burnout. Okay. Donuts, drifting, you know, that is drifting.
Okay. Not that just... It's more detailed than that.
Yes, of course. And it's not just to carry a car, speed and raise handbrake, turn around and...
That's not
what's that?
That's nothing. But you know you have to differentiate. We have to see you do the burnout, we have to see you do the donuts, and then we have to see you do the drifting.
Yeah.
And then you have to tell us what to do, what to do. Do we take the gear to this place or to this place?
Yeah.
We have to see all of that. No, I'm serious.
Yeah.
Because now we have to see the difference now. Like there's one I didn't even want to find out. The difference between the donuts where you see the car is going this way and then the drifting itself.
Exactly.
We really like to see that.
Exactly.
Okay, so you So stay tuned. We are going to see live in action. We are going to be seeing Hashim doing all the things we just talked about. We talked about burnout, donuts, and then drifting itself. We are going to see all of it. Hashim will be performing it live for us. We are going to see how drifting really is. After now, I believe you want to try out drifting. Yeah, well, I'll try out drifting after now, I tell you. Yeah, show you what drift. Show you what drift, Abby.
Your leg on the clutch, gear one, then you will match your brake and fire very well to release your clutch and to be burning. You have to turn your steering completely to the position you want to turn. You will step on the clutch, gear one, fire. Then you release your leg from the clutch immediately. So just watch. How to do it. All what you have to do, you have to turn your steering on the direction you want to turn to, completely to the end, then step your clutch, gear one, fire, release. Okay, now we're about to drift. I'm going to show you guys how to drift. The difference between doughnut and drifting. Doughnut, I did earlier that my direction of tires was same. So now I'm doing it opposite. That's the drifting. So watch out. What you have to do, you have to press the clutch, gear one, then when you fire, what you have to do is to turn the steering the other direction. Just watch out. As you can see me now, I'm turning the steering the other way.
Epic. So ladies and gentlemen, I enjoyed myself. I believe you enjoyed yourself as well. So he just told us everything we needed to know about drifting, from the burnout to the doughnuts and then to the drifting itself, how you do the whole thing. So you don't just carry your car out there and go and start drifting. Please don't do it unless you watch the video that has triggered you. All thanks to Hashim and all thanks to Papa Smurf for making all of this possible, and also Darkknight. And this, I want to say thank you, a big thank you for watching, and please stay tuned. This is what we call Shey U Wan Drift video. Check it out, keep watching it, stay tuned and enjoy. I'll just keep giving you the best you can.